Eilig Child About Reproductive Disorder. The first condition is prostatitis, which means an inflammation of the prostatic gland caused by infectious agent, maybe bacteria, fungi, mycoplasmas. Or other condition that cause this condition prostatitis is prostatic hyperplasia. As prescribed in the pictures, and to the right, normal prostate, and to the left, enlarged prostate. Sign a symptom. Weak urine stream, frequent urination, dribbling after urination, urge to urine, leakage of urine, overflow, incontinence, frequent urination during night, as described in the picture. Classification. Prostatitis classify according to the infectious agent, bacterial or abacterial, depending on the presence or absence of microorganisms in the prostatic fluid. Acute bacterial prostatitis may produce sudden fever and chills and perineal, rectal, or low back pain. And this chronic bacterial prostatitis is major cause of relapsing urinary tract infection. Complications from prostatitis include the swelling of a prostatic gland, urinary retention, bacteremia, and pyelonephritis. Other conditions include benign prostatic hyperplasia, enlarged prostate. The prostatic gland enlarges, extending outward into the bladder and obstructing the outflow of urine by encroaching on the visceral orifice. As described in the picture, to the right, normal prostate, to the left, benign enlargement of prostate. The cause is uncertain, but evidence suggests that hormones initiate hyperplasia of supporting the stromal tissue and the glandular element in the prostate. Complication: gradual dilation of the ureters, hydroureters, and kidneys hydronephrosis can occur. Urinary tract infection may result from urinary stasis. The urinary stasis may cause organisms to be proliferate and prepare environment for the organisms' proliferation. Pelvic inflammatory disease is an inflammatory condition of the pelvic cavity that may begin with cervicitis and may involve the uterus, endometriosis, fallopian tubes, salpingitis, ovaries, or arthritis, pelvic peritoneum, or pelvic vascular system. The pathophysiology, the organisms enter the body through, as described in the pictures, through the vagina, pass through the cervical canal, colonize the endocervix, and move upward into the uterus. The organism may process it to fallopian tubes and ovaries and into the pelvis. Other transmission way include in bacterial infection that occur after childbirth or abortion. Pathogens are disseminated directly through the tissue and supporting the uterus by way of lymphatic and blood vessels. Other conditions: spread of gonorrhea through the cervix and enter the uterus and then to the fallopian tubes and then to pelvic cavity. Symptoms of pelvic infection include vaginal discharge, lower abdominal pelvic pain, tenderness that occur after menses. Pain may increase while voiding, fever, general malaise, anorexia, nausea, headache, and possibly vomiting, other signs and symptoms of this infection. Complications include pelvic or generalized peritonitis, abscess, and fallopian tube obstruction may develop.